welcome to Secrets, the world's most amazing nightclub. Once again, the TV cameras have dropped in, so you're very welcome as well. In the audience tonight, give a nice, big, warm welcome to Mr. Jack Tinker, the best theatre critic of them all, sitting down the front row there. And to one of our finest actresses, Miss Honor Blackman, sitting down in the front row. Very nice. Very exciting for you tonight, Honor. What? This lady started with John Steed, then James Bond, now the ultimate, me. Okay, we're going to do an illusion. Let's do it. This is an illusion, but I want to take you all round it and through it. You can see all the way under it. Remember that. You can also see the front of the front door. What you have not seen so far is the back of the front door. This is the back of the front door. If I go all the way around and open up the back door like this, you're looking at the front of the back door. The bit you haven't seen is the back of the middle door. So if I open up the middle door like this, you've now seen the front and the back of the middle door. And you've seen the front and the back of the back door. The only bit that you haven't seen is the front of the back door itself. So if I close the back door like that, and then I close the middle door like this, you've now seen the front and the back of all of the doors. The thing that's missing, of course, is this. The one thing that makes this show popular is Miss Debbie McGee.
Good evening. May I join you for a moment? I'm your entertainment, whether you like it or not. My name is Bill. How do you do, John? This is my favorite part of the show. It's me. Thanks. Try to laugh it up, okay, Jack? Thanks. First of all, I'm going to start off with a quick card trick. Can you see all the cards? Just say yes.
Yes.
Okay, we're off to a good start. It really is a regular deck of cards. I'm going to shuffle them up. Okay, I'm going to start with you, okay? I'm going to let you select any card. And what I want you to do is just pick out anyone you like. Don't let me influence. I'm sorry. Let me get that. I apologize. That was my fault. Anyone. But is that you or me? I'm sorry. Take any card you like. Whatever you do, don't let me see it. Look at it. Show it to everyone. I won't look. Just kidding. Show it. Remember that card and place it right on top, please. Thank you. Nobody has ever done it that well. She does good, Jen. She does very good. Now, I'm going to make you a deal. If I don't get your card on the first try, you get $100. Or 100 pounds. That's even more. A lot better. But you don't get it from me. You get it from John. Thanks a lot, John. I knew he'd like this. Hold both your hands out flat. This has nothing to do with the trick. Look at John. Do me, Bill, do me. Settle down, John. Settle down. Remember, if I don't find the card, you get the 50 pounds.
See what else?
No. Don't worry about it. It was a black card, spade, the three of spade. Right? Seriously? What was it? Name it out loud, quick.
Quick. Queen of diamonds.
Are you serious? Isn't that what I showed you? Come on now. If you're going to lie to me, Faye, I'm not going to do the drink. Thank you, thank you. Please try to applaud and make it look like a crowd in here. Thank you. Just move around a little bit. Excuse me one second. Sorry, I have a bad cold. That's going to happen. Let me try a hard one. Angela, would you please take one this time? Anyone? That's a beautiful watch. Does that come off? Never mind. If I need it, I'll get it. Show it to everyone just like before. I won't look. John, make sure you see it too. Everyone, remember the card. Put it right on the top. Watch my hands. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. Your card is now on top. Oh, one little thing. Tens are wild. I always forget to. Let me explain. Look, if you get a wild card, all you do is this. Let me start this over. I'll do it one more time. Wow. I'll slow it down. Thank you. Settle down, sir. Thank you. Put the money away. Stop it. Cut it out. You guys kill me. Look, we'll take the eight. We'll put it in the deck upside down. To get it back, we take the jack, go up, down, you get the eight. Now we'll try it the hard way. I'll bring you backstage. I'll show you how it works. Bend it down the middle, put it in there while it's bent. All we do is say up. Boy, this guy's good. I'm coming here again. Settle down. Eat your heart out, John. Of course, the part that I don't like, if you rub it the wrong way, now it's not on the top or the bottom. Do you know why? It's in my pocket. And I don't even have a pocket. You guys, excuse me a minute. Sorry, can I have some applause, please? Thank you. This is not a free ride. Thank you. I feel like having a drink myself here. Let me do one more, and then I got to go because I have a show in April. John, would you please select the card, sir? Thank you. We didn't want to leave you out. Okay? And just like before, show it to everyone. I will look. Now, here's what we're going to do to make it into. You put it back in there any way you like. Okay? Anywhere but there. That's a make it hard for me. That's okay, John. Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to let John find his own card. That way, if I miss, all the blame will go on John. But don't worry, I'm going to help you. Oh, nothing yet. I'm going to spread out the cards. I'll make you a deal, John. Any card you put in my hand will be your card. All I ask, don't turn it over. Put it face down in my hand. Any card, it will be yours. Any card. Put it face down, please. Okay, are you ready? Do you remember the card? Is that it? Darn it, I should have done it myself. I don't know why I asked you to help me. I really don't. Well, folks, I'm going to do one last trick, and then I hope you enjoy the show. We have a lot more entertainment for you tonight. Whatever you're having, just tell them to total up the check and then pay it. Angela, as I do this, you say stop.
Stop.
Have a very nice evening. Hope you enjoyed the performance. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're enjoying the show so far, because tonight going around the tables we've got Bill Malone. He's from Boca Raton in Florida. Now, if you were to head a bit north, a long way north, you get to Canada. And just close to Niagara Falls is where I found this next artist. He's brilliant. He's a very young magician. Give him a big secrets welcome. It's Greg Frewin. Isn't that a good act? That's Greg Frewin, he's from Canada. Yeah. It's not the birds that baffle me, it's where do you keep all the millet, you know? Here's a quick trick, let's do a quick trick for you. This is a handkerchief, obviously, and this is a yellow board, and this is a red board. I'm throwing everything down so you can see everything. And there are £4 coins and nothing else. And all you have to do is put a coin there, a coin there, a coin there, a coin there. And you can see that's all they are, pound coins. Now you've got to keep your eyes on the ones that are uncovered. So if I cover these two, you watch these two. If I cover these two, like this, okay, then you would be watching for the two closest to me. Say yes, Paul.
Yes, Paul.
Can you see that? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now if you do this, like this, you see, like that, or you do that, then the two that are covered are always the ones that are uninteresting. Watch this. I do that and go flick like that, okay? And there it is over there. Now the trick is to get it from here across and underneath the board. And the way you do it is you just go like that and you go flick, flack, flick. And there it is under there. Now let's try it again. Let's try the hard one. The hard one is this, okay? You just give a little wave over the top of that. Very good. Pick it up. It's gone. Very good. Now,
how my money goes.
Wave over there. Pick it up. Fall back. Okay? Now that's, all right, doing it the hard way. All right? The hard way. Try this way. One, two, three, four. Watch. One, two, three, four. How many coins are there?
Four.
How many coins are there?
Four.
Right. One, two, three, and suddenly one leaves here and goes over there. If you go like that, one leaves here, goes over there. Go like that, one leaves here, goes over there. Did you follow that?
Not quite.
Not quite. No, well, in that case, you lose all your money.
Thank you.
We have a top-class act from Great Britain, Les Bubb.
Thank you, thank you. Oh,
Huh? What? Huh? Hey, hey! Boy! Beautiful strains of the theme from Love Story played by Dick Van Winkle, which is not his real name. His real name is Mary Van Winkle. Please, I should like to tell the story of Romeo and Juliet, the greatest love story of all time. This represents Romeo, blue for a boy. And we'll just tie a little knot at the end, a kind of a love knot, I guess. And this represents Juliet, pink for a girl. Story begins in Verona, where they met in a garden and kissed, and then indulged in hanky-panky. Oh, please, this is a serious story. If only we had a garden, I could show you, but where are you going to find a garden on a night like this? We shall enter the garden, perchance, to play the parts. Romeo concealed himself on one side of the garden so that Juliet would not see him. In truth, at that stage, he didn't know he was looking for Juliet, who was hidden on this side of the garden. And there they were in a flower-strewn bower. Suddenly, and without warning, Romeo did something strange. He kind of popped his cork and started to say to himself, "I feel bad." In fact, he said, "Bad, I'm bad." That's what he said. And he was out there. He was doing his thing. In fact, this man was going wild, trying to find the girl of his dreams. A kind of a pretty woman was what he was looking for. And there she was, waiting for him. So he nipped over and said, "Said you had a beautiful body, would you hold it against me?" And she said, "You're the one that I want. You're the one." And so they leapt about together, and she said, "Why don't we go in the greenhouse?" So they went into the greenhouse. There was no stopping them. It's a sordid tale. And in they went to the greenhouse, and as they went in, that's when the hanky-panky took place. And I have to tell you, more than hanky-panky took place. They decided to get married, and they decided to have a family. "Well, yes, we are family," they said. And because they were family, so the story goes, they all went back into the bottle, and they all lived happily ever after. And that's the story. It's a love story.
Boy, am I going to go there? Speak more, I feel. I get nervous after watching something that good. You don't mind if I have a quick cigarette just before I begin?
No.
You don't mind, do you, sir? Thanks. Okay, I feel better. Thanks a lot. You want one? You okay? I'm just checking. What I'm going to do, as you know, I do a lot of card tricks. So I'm going to show you. Have you ever heard of a place called Las Vegas? Little small town, middle of a desert. What I'm going to do is show you how a dealer in Las Vegas, Monte Carlo, or even my house would cheat you in a card game. Not that we do. Don't get me wrong, sir. Could you keep it down, please, a little? But what I will do, I will show you how a dealer would cheat you. Now, to start off, because it's a demonstration, I'll remove four cards from the deck to make this easy to follow, okay? We'll use this one, and this one. Now, your job is to keep your eye on those four cards, because what a dealer would do... I'm sorry, was that too fast? Let me slow down. I'll slow down. This one, and this one. Is that better? Yeah. Can I do good? I did good. Thank you. Now, the first thing we're going to do... No, hold the applause. Stop it. Cut it out. Stop it. No, put the money away. The first thing we're going to do is show you how a dealer would control the cards during a card game. We're going to place the four aces in different parts of the deck like this. Okay? Each one's in a different part. They really are. You're checking me out, aren't you? You want me, don't you? She's looking at you. It's wild. Okay, I'll talk to you in a minute. Four aces, each one in a different part of the deck. First of all, what a dealer would do, or what it would look like he's doing, is mixing up the cards, but a good dealer would have complete control over the four aces all the time. Now, not only am I going to try to keep those aces under my control, but I'm going to try to cut to each one without looking. There's no aces on top, no aces on the bottom. If I want to get an ace out of the deck, all I do is cut the cards right about the center, and if I'm right, that's the first one. Yes!
Yeah.
Bill Malone! Bill Malone! Yes, what a good! God, we're having a good time. Second one comes out of the deck by giving the deck a little spin like this, like that. Boy, this guy's good. Settle down, sir, cut it out, stop it. Third one comes out of the deck almost by itself. Watch, come on, up, up. Yes, yeah. That's the third one. That's the ace that I'm gonna take here. It's as good as I get, so laugh it up now. And the last one comes out the hard way. We take two cards, the four of spades, also the nine of diamonds. Little riffle? Anybody for poker? Blackjack, 21, yeah. Running? Thank you. Excuse me. Hope you enjoyed the show. Thank you very much. Have a good night. Yes! Bill Malone! Bill Malone!
From the Ukraine, and I think it's one of the most beautiful acts I've ever seen. So please welcome Svetlana.
Thank you.
practice that myself when I get home tonight. Could you do me a favour? Would you, if you've got anything, is this your wife?
Yes.
Of course. Would you take out anything from your inside pockets that, you know, you want to keep and just put it on the table? Have you got things in your inside pockets, wallets and things?
No.
No? Oh, fine. Oh, you've been there already. Right. What's your name?
Ian.
Ian. Welcome, Ian, to Secrets, the world's most amazing nightclub. You're on stage. Let's have a big round of applause for Ian. Come around here, Ian. Step up there. This is showbiz. Over the other side, Ian. Over the other side. Keep moving, otherwise you stop them seeing the star. Now, where are you from, Ian?
Manchester.
Manchester, lad. It used to be great up there, eh? When all them clubs were going and all that, before that daft police inspector closed them all down, eh? He's a very nice man. Now, listen.
Very nice man.
Who's working you? What's going on?
Say that.
They always do that, they yeah. Do. Very, very nice man, yes.
Come on, get on with the trick.
Pardon?
Get on with the trick.
I was going to get on with it till you started. Now, listen. Don't talk to me. I'm armed, all right? Now, this is a Bowie knife, all right? Used to belong to David.
Yep.
And it's sharp, see? Good, eh?
Yeah.
Ooh. And I've been practicing. You'll be pleased to hear. I've been practicing with all this stuff. I've got a scarf. See, it's got a hole in as well. Little hole in the scarf. Oh, ah, Jim Lamb. And that's to fit over the top of there. I've got one of these. This is a target. You see, this is a target. Like that, see? And that fits on there as well. And I stand over there, you see? And you hold this target like that. Now listen, the target goes back on the tray. Yeah. Like that, that's important. And this, hold that a second. That way up. All right? Like that. And, I tell you what would work better. Can I borrow your jacket? Can I borrow your jacket? That's the best Bobby Ball impression I've seen in years. Now, put the jacket on there. The other way around. That's it. Because this is a silent valet, you know. Right, leave the knob sticking out. Right, this. Now, nice jacket. Oh, look, side vents. Do you ever wear them with a centre bent?
No.
You will before we're through with this. Right. Just get rid of that. See, I'm all fumble-fingered because, you know, sometimes we just put a trick into the club just for practice. You know, now. Right. Hold that. And this is the target. And we put the target on there like that, okay? Now we've got something to aim at, see? Would you try it yourself, first of all? Come round here, see, just pull your coat. Oh, that's in the way a bit, isn't it? You can't see this. There's a thing round the back in the way. And all you do is you just pull it back and point to somewhere on there, just gently. Where would you... Centre vent. Centre vent, Ian. Now, go around the front, Ian. Go around the front. I'll try and hit that point for you. All right. You think it was about there, yes? Mm. Okay, centre vent. You asked for it. Now, just hang on a second. Where is it? About there, you said. Nah, you missed. Now you missed. Look, you're way off. You should have been up there like that, shouldn't you? You should have been up there or even up there. Would have been better than down there, wouldn't it, Ian?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course it would. Well, that's gone awfully wrong. If we just get rid of that, that's gone. It's gone wrong.
Yeah, not again.
He missed. What do you mean, not again? BBC insurance policy will cover it. Now then, I think I've got it. Yeah, great. Much better. Yeah. Look. That's it. Yeah. See, you should have been up there. Shame, really. Well, if we just take that off there, like that, you see, and you can see how it's all sort of gathered up, a bit rough-like, isn't it? Say yes, Paul.
Yes, Paul.
It is. Anyway, I can't get it through. But look, this is... a very sharp knife. And in all the time I've been doing this trick, that knife has never been damaged once. And stitches are very important, I find, you know, if you cut yourself. So, there's the knife, there's the knife, there's your jacket. It's all as it was in the beginning. Thanks, Ian, for being a good sport.
You do.
Enjoy your night in the club. There you go.
Helicopter.
you enjoyed that one. I have another one if you like. May I do another one?
Please.
I'll tell you what, instead of doing a card trick like most magicians would do, let me tell you a story. Do you like stories?
Yes.
Oh, wait, I'm sorry. Before I go on, Miss Blackman, I just wanted to say welcome to my show. And by the way, we have a gentleman named Paul Daniels on tonight, too, so I hope you enjoy
well,
him as
well. I know his baby.
Good, very, very good. Now, this is a story of a guy called Sam the Bellhop in the 654 Club. Have you ever been in a 654 Club? You don't go out that much. It's okay. Don't worry. I'll keep your little secret. See, one day, Sam the Bellhop was sitting in his restaurant, and it was kind of slow that night, almost like here. But all of a sudden, out of nowhere, the two big doors opened up wide, and into the restaurant walked four gentlemen dressed up like kings. That's what they look like, members of royalty. So they're sitting there for a little while, and they're getting kind of bored, so they called Sam over. They said, excuse us, Sam, this is our first time here, and we're kind of lonely. Would you do us a favor? Would you find us some women to help make the time go by? Sam looked at his watch and said, well, it's kind of early, but I'll see what I can do. So the cards were cut. Sir, would you please cut the cards? Thank you, sir. Wow, nobody has ever done it that well. You did a fine job. He's good. So the cards were cut. Sam took a little walk. He went 1, 2, 3 blocks and said the best we could do is a couple brunettes and a couple of redheads. They said, Sam, that's what they said. They said, Sam, they're beautiful. Where'd you get them? He said, oh, the 654 Club. It's right down the block. They said, Sam, you're a heck of a guy. Here's a $2 tip for you, Sam, a $2 tip. So now they're sitting there with the girls, if you know what I mean, and I think you do, sir. All of a sudden, they get kind of bored and they feel like having a game of cards. The only trouble is they don't have enough card players. They said, Sam, would you do us a favor? Would you find us some card players? Sam said, well, it's still kind of early, but I'll see what I can do. So the cards were cut again. Mrs. Bobbitt, would you please make the cut? I'm sorry. Hope that's not your real name. So I mean it. So the cards were cut again. Sam took another walk. 1, 2, even took a left down Crimp Street and said, the best I could do is 4 guys, but they're all named Jack. They said, well, Sam, that's great. Where'd you get them? He said, oh, the 654 Club right down the block. They said, Sam, you really are a heck of a guy. Here's another $2 tip for you. So now they're in this big poker game. All of a sudden, the Kings run into some bad luck and they owe the girls some money. The only problem is all they have is a $40 check. They said, Sam, would you do us a favor? Would you cash the check and get us a couple of 20s? Sam said, well, I'd even have this when I came in here. I love my job. Sam said, well, it's still kind of early, but I'll see what I can do. So the cards were cut once more. Miss Blackman, would you please cut? Thank you. I love your jewelry. Does that come off? Never mind, just asking. So the cards were cut. Sam took another walk. 1, 2, 3 more blocks. Said, the best we could do, we're all out of 20s. We had to give you 4 tens. They said, well, Sam, that's great. Here's another $2 tip for you. So now they're really starting to like this guy, Sam. They said, you know what, Sam? This is our first time here, but we're coming here again. They said, you really are a nice guy. You remind us of that magician, Bill Malone. He says, oh, well, thank you. Nobody's that nice for crying out loud. They said, Sam, you're kind of a young guy. He said, well, kind of. They said, we guess your age to be, what, about 38? He says, you're close. I'm 39. They said, do you live here at the club? He says, oh, no. I live at 1329 West 8th Street. They said, do you gamble? He says, every day at the 654 Club. It's right down the block. They said, do you ever see any good poker hands? They said, you wouldn't believe it. The other day, Paul Daniels came by. He had 3 7s and a pair of 8s. They said, wow, that's a full house. Did he win? They said, no, Miss Blackman, she was there. She had 3 aces and a pair of 9s. They said, did she win? They said, no, Bill Malone, the magician, he had a straight flush. And that's the story of Sam the Bellhop, the 654 Club. Yes, Bill Malone. Bill Malone! Bill Malone!
Miss Honor Blackman has been going around and watching the close-up and the stage magic, and we've kind of ignored one man, Mr. Jack Tinker, and there's a reason for that. The reason is that we needed an independent adjudicator. My favorite kind of illusion is levitation, but recently the press have said it's all done with wires and cables. So we have lit the background fairly lightly so that you'll be able to see at home should there be any such devices used. And I'd like you to give a nice round of applause to the man that's going to check upon that for you, Jack Tinker, on stage right now. Welcome to the world of wonder, Jack. Now, this is show business. These are the wings, these are the flies. Those things sound asleep over there. That's Eamon and the stage crew. And that's showbiz. And we're going to build an illusion in front of you. Now, this is a metal structure, a strut, what have you. And we fit it to a mark. I mean, you can see there's no moving parts on that. And we just put it to a mark on the stage, which means that we know it's in exactly the right place when we put this one on the stage here. And it is vital that this one is as far away from that one is from this one.
Amazing.
And you now we have a plank brought on by Warren and Alan, two of the finest dancers in the world. Come out from behind there, you're a star. Now, you have to make sure it's on there firmly so that there's nothing can go wrong, you see. Now then, this will give you more than a bit of a thrill. This is wonderful. Would you please welcome Debbie McGee? Now, there's Debbie. And Debbie has been already preconditioned for this, Jack. All I do is I say relax, 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 and sleep. Now, we bring her here. Like that. And we've got to get her about the middle. So I think we move her just a touch towards you. A bit back. That's it. It's vital that we get her absolutely balanced perfectly. And just a touch towards me. That's very good. Now, Jack, you're here to make sure she's not connected to anything. So you do the magic wave over the top. You know, I'd give you a good write-up for that. That was beautifully done. You know, absolutely beautifully done. Now, you agree. You've seen the struts, you've seen the plank, everything, yep. Now, if you come, just come here a second, look. If I hold this like this, these sometimes are a little bit stiff to get out from under there, but if we get them out like that, see? Now, as long as I'm like this and stand like that, the audience thinks that she's kind of magically balanced. You must never take this hand away. You take this hand away, you're in stuck. I mean, look around here. Look. Okay?
Yes.
She is now unbalanced. Now, her mother thought she was when she married me. I know all that, yeah. But take one tour right round it, Jack. Take a tour right round it, making sure. And in fact, I'll let you, even let you do the thing magicians do.
What?
Which, well, they do the hoop bit.
Oh, I see. Oh, right.
Oh, the hoop bit. See, there's the hoop.
Thanks.
See? Good, eh? Yes. And you put it over this end and down to the floor. That's it. No, I meant right down to the floor.
Oh, I see.
Right up there, you see.
Oh,
then
I see,
there can't possibly be anything holding her up. You go right over there like that, see? And down. And back again. See? And that just means now that you, for the first time, Jack Tinker, have performed your first illusion. We give that back to the girl and we say thanks very much for taking part. Be careful as you go off back to sleep. Nice round of applause for Mr. Jack Tinker. Now, as if that wasn't enough, we're going to try something a little more. I'm going to just try to just titivate up the dress. Could you fellas just do me a favour and just support her a little bit, all right? Can you just take away that for me, please? Can you just take it away? Can you just angle it down? Can you just try taking the plank away? You'll be fine. You'll be fine. Just relax. Just relax. Now. Thank you. she's covered over. Drop in next time. Don't forget, the best magician in the world appear here in secret, the world's most amazing angle. Big thanks, of course, to Jack and to Honor for being with us tonight, and to all the other artists, the orchestra, but chiefly yourselves. See you next time in secrets. Bye for now. Bye-bye.
You have your say next on BBC One. Stay tuned for Points of View.